Hello students of standard 8. In geography, you are learning about population. Today you are going to learn chapter 2, population part 2, in which you are going to learn about the distribution of population. What do you mean by the distribution of population? The manner in which the people are living all over the world, in the continents or countries, known as distribution of population. When you see all over the world and the world's population, there are some areas where there is large population or high population density. If you see some of the areas, dry areas, lack of settlements, or less people are living there. Why? What do you think? There are many factors on which the distribution of population depends. There are some physical factors and there are some non-physical factors. Which are the physical factors affecting the distribution of population? The physical factors are landforms, climate, soil, availability of water and mineral and power resources. Landforms, how do they affect the distribution of population? If you see the landforms on the surface of the earth, there are high mountains, plateaus and plains. So, when you see the plains, they are well developed. They are densely populated. At some areas, they are overpopulated. People like to be settled on the plain areas where there is good fertile land and all other facilities like transport and other development is found there. Second, the climate condition. No one can live or like to be settled in the desert area where there is extreme climate. Summer is very hot and in this condition no settlement is found there. In the outskirts part of the desert, maybe some of the population can be seen. So the river valleys, if you see, where there is good climate, or the hill stations where there is cool climate, or the seashore where there is equable climate, people like to be settled. And there is all round development also. Transport facilities, water facilities, other facilities are also seen, can be seen there. Next is the soil. Very good fertile soil. Where there is, people like to be settled because they can cultivate different crops. Where there is barren land or rocky area, that is difficult to be settled because other sources of water also cannot be found there. Availability of water. Where there is water available, people like to be settled. First of all, in the river valleys, where water is available, many civilizations develop. And because of the water facility, which is our basic need, people like to be settled. For all purposes, water is an important need. And without water, no one can live. So, it is an important factor and which should be found there, where there is population or where there is sources of water, there is high population density and people are also found there overcrowding. Next is the availability of mineral and power resources. Where there are minerals, people like to go to settle there because they get job opportunities. And where there is industries, due to the minerals develop, they are also well developed, connected with roadways, connected with electricity, all housing colonies or hospitals and schools for the children, like that all development can be seen in that area. So population distribution depends on the facilities where mineral resources are found. Power resources like coal, petroleum, where they are found, they are being utilized for generating electricity. And where there is all facilities of electricity, people like to enjoy their life. And therefore, in the cities, there are lot of population, large population is found and seen in the cities where there is all facility. There are many facilities related to education or hospitals or other facilities. Now you can see the population density or density of population. What do you mean by the density of population? Number of people per unit area of land. So in 1 square kilometer area, how many people are living? That is known as density of population. So if you see the world's density of population, it is about 50 persons per square kilometer. That means in 1 square kilometer area, if it is distributed evenly, 50 people can be settled there or found there. So if you see related to the factors or the people living in a particular area, there is high density of population in some of the cities. Though the cities are very small, there is very high density of population. There are some countries where there is very high density of population. Like our country, India, is famous for its highest density of population, ranking after China, second ranking. And our neighbors or neighbor countries like Bangladesh, Pakistan or South Korea, all these are having very high density of population. In 1 square kilometer area, more than 1,000 people are living. There are some small countries or cities also overcrowded there. Like some countries in the world, the smallest country, Vatican City, Andorra, Bahrain, all these are overcrowded, or we can say there is very high density of population. Some cities which are well developed, they have very high density of population. So like in our country, Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, there is very high density of population. Sorry, I couldn't explain. I explain only physical factors, and non-physical factors are also there which affect the distribution of population. So they are some of the cultural factors like availability of educational and health care. There are also presence of industries, and in that area all round development can be seen. Transport facilities or facilities for the workers, housing colonies, for their children, schools and hospitals. So like that, non-physical factors are also responsible to change the distribution of population. In the areas or in the country or city where there is no violence, no war, there is peaceful situation, there is no other condition, the political situation also is balanced, and there is freedom to obey their religion. So like these areas, people like to be settled. So these are some of the non-physical factors which affect the distribution of population. Thank you.